Hello and welcome back to the channel. In today's tutorial, let's talk about the Multibrush tool and how to use it in your illustrations or designs. First, I am going to create a new layer and lock the background. Grab the Multibrush tool in the toolbox. It is a button that looks like three brushes connected to one another. To activate the tool, you can click on the button or you can hit the letter Q on your keyboard for the shortcut. A new set of action buttons have now appeared in the Tool Options Docker. To create a smoother line, so you have the option here to activate the stabilizer. You are more than welcome to copy my settings. Here I have set the sample count to 50 and the delay to 10. Now make sure to tweak these settings if it don't work for you. You can also activate or deactivate the pen pressure button. The Multibrush tool offers five distinct modes for you to play with. To access them, simply click on this little small arrow next to the Type drop-down menu. The modes are Symmetry, Mirror, Translate, Snowflake, and Copy Translate. We are going to start with the first mode. Before we begin, I'd like to draw your attention to a few key details. First, you'll notice a line on the canvas. Think of these as your guides. They provide a visual representation of the sections on the canvas. Now, Krita uses the term brushes and has provided us with a slider to adjust the number of brushes. Currently, you can see it is set to 3 brushes, which equates to 3 sections. Now, if I paint a line on the canvas, I will get 3 copies of it. The symmetry mode allows us to create lines that will be replicated around the central point. Now, before I go any further, it's important to note that the techniques I'm about to show you now will also be applicable to the mirror and the snowflake modes. So that said, when we reach these two next modes, please keep in mind that I won't repeat what I'm about to say now, just trying to not waste your time. You can increase or decrease the number of sections displayed on your canvas by using the brushes slider. To rotate the angles of the guides, you can use this level, or you can use the up and down arrows. Finally, you have the option to type a value into the input box. To return the rotation angle to its original settings, simply type a 0 into the input box and press the Enter key. The central point or central axis that you see here can also be called the origin point. You can relocate it across the canvas by clicking on the Move button. So for example, draw a flower. Click on the Move button. Relocate the origin point somewhere else. And draw another flower. To reset the origin point to the center of the canvas, simply click on the Reset button. If you find the guides distracting, you can opt to hide them. To do so, uncheck the Show Origin box. Keep in mind that this won't deactivate the mode itself. The mode will remain active, but the guides will no longer be visible. Personally, I prefer to have a visual reference, so I'll leave that option enabled. This option acts exactly like the two mirror tools located in our toolbox. Any line you draw on one side of either guidelines will be automatically duplicated on the opposite side. You can decide if you want your lines to be mirrored horizontally only or vertically only by checking or unchecking these boxes. This mode is very similar to the symmetry mode, but offers more segments for added complexity. Use different layers if you are going to create a colorful mandala pattern. I would suggest you use different layers. This way, if you don't like one color, you can always change it without disturbing the other colors located on other layers. Don't forget that you can use different modes in one drawing. You can switch between modes while creating your design. The Translate mode offers everything like the other modes, except we have an additional slider. Under the brushes slider is the radius slider. Also, you need to know that the guides shown on the canvas don't do anything here, meaning that whatever you draw on one section won't be mirrored. For this particular mode, you can uncheck the Show Origin button to hide the guides. Same for the rotation option, don't bother with it. When using the Translate mode, it's like using the freehand brush. So you are in control and you are the one creating your own rotations. To paint fur or hair, find the settings that best fit your projects, meaning fine-tune the radius and the brush's settings. For instance, here I have three brushes with a low radius value. When I paint, the lines are very close to each other. Increase the values of your radius and the lines will get more separated. Make sure to play with the different opacity, size and flow settings. Use layers to separate your colors or textures. Finally, don't forget to make a good use of your blending modes. Use a multiply to add shadows and overlay or screen to add highlights. Check the Show Origin box again. This time, when we select the mode Copy Translate, we lose the brushes and radius sliders. However, we are given two new buttons, Add and Remove All. These buttons allow you to add sub-brushes. Let me show you. First, click on the Add button. Let's say that you want to draw a repeating pattern of flowers at different distances of each other. Click on the canvas to set your different points. When you are done deciding where your flowers or designs are going to be, click once more on the Add button to activate the brush. Now paint. Now move somewhere else on the canvas and draw more flowers. The new batch of flowers will maintain the same spacing between them as the initial set. So we are done for today. I hope this tutorial was helpful. Have fun creating mandala patterns or painting hair or fur using this wonderful tool. I will see you next time. Until then, happy creating. Au revoir et à bientôt.